Hello student, today we are going to learn Microsoft Excel. Before we start Excel, let's discuss few application and uses of Microsoft Excel. Microsoft Excel is a proprietary commercial spreadsheet application. It is an electronic spreadsheet program that can be used for storing and organizing data. It is a very widely applied spreadsheet. Features of Excel. Search and exploration of data of large sizes. Professionally looking charts and graphs with 3D effects can easily be designed in this software. Data can be filtered and sorted. Formulas can be applied based on the values entered in different cells. Applications of Excel. To perform mathematical calculation easily in daily life, inventory management, create forms and consolidate results, corporate budgeting, analytical tool, and so on. So let's move on to the practical part of Excel, that how we start Microsoft Excel. To open Excel, click on this icon. You will get these options that what kind of file or template you want to open. As Excel is used for various calculation purposes like making monthly budgets, making bills, so depending upon your need, you can select different templates or simply you can click on this blank workbook. I'll be starting with this blank workbook to make you familiar with the basic terminology of Excel. So this is the basic interface of Excel. If you will see, there are different tabs available on top of the screen like home, insert, page layout, formula, and so on. All these tabs has further options available. Let's explore these tabs. If you will click on home tab, this area, this complete area is known as ribbon. And further ribbon is divided into various groups. Like in home tab, ribbon has different groups called clipboard, font, alignment, number, and so on. If you click the page layout, all the options related to page are available in this ribbon in different groups. Like this, if I consider this page setup group, it has various options related to the page setup. Like what is the orientation, you want your file in portrait mode or landscape mode. From here, you can select the size of the page also. Click on this small arrow. See, there are different options. Page size options are available. According to your need, you can select legal, A3, A4, and so on. If you will notice this group, you will see that there is a small arrow at the corner of few groups. Like themes doesn't have this. But if you will see this page setup group, it has a small arrow over here. This group also has. So now what is this arrow? This arrow is known as launch button. If you will click on this arrow, you will get further options related to that particular group. For example, I have clicked on launch option of page setup group. So all the options related to page I can see in this group. For example, the further options are page, all the options related to page. If I click on margins, I can set the margin for my page. Click on header and footer, I can insert header and footer for my page. Let's take one more example. If I'll go to home tab, this group called font has a launch button. Click on this, then I'll get more options related to the font, like font style, font size, color of the font. See, if I'll click, I'll get various colors to apply. So these groups are has launch button also. Now comes the next thing. If you will notice, some alphabets are written over here. These alphabets are known as columns. Columns are the vertical representation. And if you will click on these numbers, you will see these numbers are known as rows. So Excel screen is basically made up of columns and rows. And these rectangular box, which is similar to your maths notebook in junior classes, these boxes are known as cells. So intersection of a column and a row is called cell. And every cell has the unique address. This is called cell address. If I click on some other cell, see, E6 is getting highlighted. So the address for this cell is E6. For giving the cell address, first we will write column name and then we will write row number. This is I6. This is N10. See, there is a difference between N10 and 10N. 10N is wrong cell address. The correct cell address is N10. Okay? So, the cell address you will make using column name first and then row number. So, this is how you give the address to the cell. You can see this bar as you click, keep clicking on different cell, this area, look at this area. As I keep clicking on the worksheet, this address will keep on changing. See, now it is D7. Now this is K12. So depending upon the mouse pointer, wherever I'll click, that particular cell is getting dark boundary. See, now J6 is having the dark color boundary. This is C5. This particular cell is active cell. Wherever you click, that cell will become your active cell and you can start typing from that particular cell. See, wherever I am clicking, I can start typing from there. So, now there's one more thing I want to tell you here is cell range. Suppose I have selected this entire area. Now, this entire area is called cell range because there are many cells together. So, cell range also has some cell address. For example, this particular area I have selected. Now, what is the cell address of this cell range? We will start from the corner one, this cell. So, the cell address of this is, as you can see, C4. Okay. So, the cell range we will specify is C4 to G13. Okay? Again, what will be the address of this cell range? Starting from this corner, that is I5 to L14. Okay? Cell range and cell addresses plays a very important role when you use formulas and functions, which we will do further. But you need to understand the basic concept of cell address and cell range because it is very much essential for putting the formulas and functions. Now, the one more important thing is, as you see here, this is written sheet 1. Sheet 1 is kind of pages, like your notebook has different pages. All pages together makes a book. Same in Excel, different sheets combined together to make a workbook, like sheet 1.